Hello students, it is I, Mr. Mikasa, and we're back with another edition of Mr. Mikasa's Digital Lessons. And this digital lesson is for my 7th grade social studies class, and we're continuing on with our Alexander the Great documents-based questions. So last time we met together, you guys worked on documents Alpha as well as Bravo. You guys answered your questions in race format after analyzing your primary and secondary sources. So today, we're continuing on with that process by working on document C for Charlie and document D for Delta. So let's go ahead and get those zoomed in real quick, and let's go and talk about these real quick. So for document C, the source is made by Peter Green. The book is called Alexander of Macedon from the University of California Press in 1991. So because of that, due to the date that we see here in the back here, we automatically know that this is a secondary source because this was published well after the events that took place. The notation says here, during Alexander's march down the Mediterranean coast, many cities surrendered without a fight. Some were happy to have the Persians removed. Alexander treated these cities rather kindly. Tyre was another matter. Its citizens refused to surrender. They believed their city was unconquerable because it was built on an island and protected by high walls. Alexander proceeded to build a causeway or land bridge of timber and rubble so his soldiers could cross from the mainland to the island. The city held out for 7 months, and Tyrrhenian counterattacks caused Alexander to lose many men. In the end, however, the causeway was completed and Alexander's army smashed into the city. So this is going to give you some historical context about what was going on during that time period. So let's go and see what this book has to say. It says, when the last organized resistance was broken, Alexander's soldiers ranged to the city on a ferocious manhunt. Alexander had ordered that all, except those who sought sanctuary, which is basically another word for safety in the temple, were to be slain, and his commands were executed with savage relish. The air grew thick with smoke from burning buildings. 7,000 Tyrians died, and the number would have been far higher had it not been for the men of Sidon, who had entered the cities alongside Alexander's troop. Now, if you wonder who these guys are, Sidon was a mercenary, is what they were. They were soldiers who hired their services out to Alexander the Great to fight for them alongside him for money, is basically what they did. He said, even though Tyre had been Sidon's rival for centuries, these neighbors of the victims, horrified by what they had witnessed, managed to smuggle some 15,000 of the Tyrians to safety. The great city was now utterly destroyed, and her king, Azimilic, and various other notables, including envoys from Carthage, had taken refuge in the temple of Melkart, and Alexander spared their lives. The remaining survivors, some 30,000 in number, he sold into slavery. 2,000 men of military age were crucified. And crucified means basically you're nailed to a cross and left to die. That's pretty much what that means as well. So there we have that little document there. Of course, we have our doc analysis questions that you guys will need to answer these 6 questions. And remember, when you guys answer these, you'll be answering these in race format. So keep that in mind as you guys are working on that one. So that's document Charlie. Let's move on to document Delta now. So document Delta, this book is written by, it says, Lucius Flavius Arrhenius. The name of the book, of course, is The Campaigns of Alexander, circa 130 CE. Now, the notation here says, ancient biographers as Alexander told these stories, they were retold by Arrian and modern-day historians. True or not in their detail, the stories reveal two sides of Alexander that were probably accurate. And we talked about this guy earlier about, even though this book is a very old source, it's still considered a secondary source because even though it was written at the time of Alexander. And we talked about that earlier with our earlier sources that we looked at earlier. So let's take a look at these two different legends. So we have one called The Legend of the Helmet. It says the army was crossing a desert of sand. The sun was already blazing down upon them, but they were struggling under the necessity of reaching water, which was still far away. Alexander, like everyone else, was tormented by thirst, but he was nonetheless marching on foot at the head of his men. It was all he could do to keep going, but he did so, and the result, as always, was that the men who were the better able to endure the misery when they saw that it was equally shared. Well, that basically means that the men realized that their general was going through the same hardship as they were. So because of that, they were okay with it, because it's like, hey, at least our leader's suffering with us. Because back in ancient times, this was not the case. Many generals would be perfectly fine living somewhere safe and, you know, being taken care of while their men suffered. It says, as they toiled on, a party of light infantry, which had gone off looking for water, found some, just a wretched little trickle collected in a shallow gully. They scooped up with difficulty what they could and hurried back to Alexander. Then, just before they reached him, they tipped the water into a helmet and gave it to him. Alexander, with a word of thanks for the gift, took the helmet and, in full view of his troops, poured the water on the ground. So extraordinary was the effect of this action that the water wasted by Alexander was as good as a drink for every man in the army. So this one's open to interpretation. People think he did it because he was being a snob about not wanting to drink water. Others claim that the reason why he poured the water out of the helmet was because if his men couldn't drink water, then he himself wasn't going to take a drink either. And so that's basically what he did. He wanted to make sure that, you know, his men are suffering. He wants to suffer alongside with them, not to cause any animosity. So this next source is from Ian Worthington from the book Alexander the Great, Man and God. It was published in 2004, so this is a secondary source as well. And this is what this legend has to say. It says, the legend of the hat band. It says, Alexander was himself steering the trimarine. A trimarine is a warship with three decks of oars, so it is. When a strong gust of wind fell on his broad-brimmed Macedonian hat and the band that encircled it, the hat, being rather heavy, fell into the water. However, the band was carried along by the wind and was caught by one of the reeds growing near the tomb of one of the ancient kings. One of the sailors swam off towards the band and snatched it from the reed, but he did not carry it in his hands because it would get wet while he was swimming. He therefore put it around his own head and brought it to the king. Most of the biographers of Alexander say that the king gave him a talent, which is basically about $10,000 in today's money, worth of silver, as a reward for his zeal. Then he ordered his head to be cut off because the prophets had explained that he would not allow the head that had worn the royal band to be safe. Basically, he executed the guy because how dare he wear Alexander the Great's, you know, headband. It's not his, it's his own. So he paid the guy for him saving his headband, but he killed the guy because, you know, how dare he wear clothing that doesn't belong to him, I guess. Which is actually kind of crazy. And with that, of course, ladies and gentlemen, we have four more questions, which we'll be answering in race format for those as well. All right, you guys, so take the remainder of today's class in order to work on this. Go start working on your guys' race formats. Remember, you guys do have the access to the entire diary to work on if you need to, and don't hesitate to also send me any questions if you guys have by message if you guys have any questions. So that's good to do for today's lesson, you guys. We will catch you guys in the next one later on. You guys stay classy, keep working hard, and I'll catch you guys in the next lesson. Peace out, you guys.